Hello, people of the internet. Today we're going to talk about the reasoning behind the title Surviving as a Mediocre Artist. I've gotten a lot of comments lately that have been specifically regarding the name of my series and not so much the work that's inside of the series or the stuff that I'm talking about inside the series. So I figured it would be best for me to address it in the video. I named this series specifically about the way that I feel about my own career and some of the things that I would have liked to learn early on before jumping in. And so when I started this series, I wanted to start it to help other artists and people see that if I can make it, coming from nothing, that anybody can make it. And that the feeling of mediocrity that I have is not just me. I know a ton of artists that are super talented that have the same feelings that I do. And so let me give you a little bit of background. So my schooling, the stuff that we talked about before, I didn't invest any time hardly at school, and my school wasn't very good. And so those things created the perfect storm of me leaving school with basically nothing. And so when I started out running audio at a TV station, I didn't know anything about design. I didn't know anything about art. I didn't know any of that stuff. And so as I tried to get into this field, it's very, very difficult when you don't have a portfolio and you don't have any understanding of design and stuff. It just compounds and it just gets worse and worse. It's super, super competitive in this field. And so as I've gotten better over the years and my eye has gotten better and my work has gotten better, I continue to see work that's better, right? So my eye gets better, therefore I see better work, right? So I'm like, man, that work is amazing. And so I strive to get better, right? And so then I see my work and I'm like, oh, I could have done this and this and this better. That's very mediocre. It's missing something. It's missing an extra layer to make it like exceptional, right? It's always missing something. And I always feel like I missed something, or I wish I had more time to fix this, or I wish I had more time to fix that. And then I see extraordinary work and I'm like, oh man. Then I look at my work again. I'm like, oh, it's very mediocre. And that's a feeling that I know that I'm not the only one that has that feeling, right? I'm not the only one that feels that my work is mediocre. Because I know that you guys, no matter how talented you are, I know that I've ran into a ton of crazy talented artists that have done tons of amazing work that still feel like they're okay. They do all right. They do okay work, but they don't ever consider themselves great, right? And so me, I feel like the same thing, right? Like I do okay work. You know, and some people that are outside of the field or even in the field, they're like, oh man, that's amazing, right? But I still feel like my work is very mediocre, which gives me the drive to continue to get better and better and better. I never consider myself mediocre and then I just settle in mediocrity. I don't settle in mediocrity. I use the feeling of being mediocre as a drive and a pedestal to be better. Like I constantly want to be better. I constantly see better work and I'm trying to strive to learn the reasoning why that's better and why this looks like that and why that lighting works like this and why this model looks like that and whatever, and tries to get better and better and better, because I don't think I'll ever consider myself the best, because there's no way that you could ever consider yourself the best. There's too much talent out there to ever consider yourself better or better than somebody else, right? Because there's so many people that are amazingly talented out there. But I also know that it's a mental state, right? A lot of people will they'll see these works and they see these things and they're like, man, my work sucks. And then they won't even try. And that's not what this is about. That's not what my career has ever been about. I see this other work and I use that as a, man, I just got to get better. You know, my work is very mediocre. I need to get better at these areas. And so I constantly strive. And I feel like you guys need to understand that the mediocrity is not a settling point. I'm not settling for the middle. I'm not settling for what that is. I see the other work. I just see what my work, what I feel like in my heart, my work is, right? I'm like, ah, this could have been better. I wish I had more time to do this. I wish I had more time to do that. I wish I could have seen this a little bit different to fix these things. But I know you guys do too. You constantly look back at work that you guys have worked on and you're like, man, I wish I had more time to fix this or do these things or, you know, whatever it is, right? So hopefully you guys understand a little bit more about what I'm saying when I say that I'm surviving as a mediocre artist, because I started this channel to hopefully help others see a little bit differently and see the work a little bit differently and be encouraged by some of the things that are happening in this environment, because this environment is very, very negative at times. And we should be super excited to be in this field, and we should always help push each other forward. So thank you guys so much for taking the time to watch these videos and comment and, you know, go through those things. And so if you guys have anything you guys want me to cover or talk about, or if you guys have any other comments about, you know, the way that I see mediocrity, you know, those are all awesome things. And I appreciate every single minute that I'm able to spend on this mic to talk to you guys. So if you guys have anything else that you guys like to talk about, please let me know. Email, comment, share, subscribe this channel. As we grow, hopefully we'll just continue to have these great conversations. Thank you guys so much for your time. I'll see you in the next video.